In today's episode, I'm taking you on a tour of what may be considered the most unique apartment in all of New York City. A gorgeous $7 million ultra-modern apartment directly across the street from Central Park. The apartment was the former ballroom of a luxury hotel, and it was inspired by the renowned architect Antoni Gaudí, the architect responsible for designing the world-famous La Sagrada Familia in Barcelona. Let's go enter this architectural masterpiece. Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. I have another amazing apartment tour for you guys here today. This is a $7 million apartment in New York City. It's an ultra modern listing. I'm here with my friend John from the Corcoran Group.
Hi everybody, John Gascasca from Corcoran. Thanks a lot, Mike, for the intro. Welcome to 106 Central Park South, apartment 3A. This phenomenal three bed, three and a half bathroom condo situated directly across the street from Central Park, 15 foot ceilings, these ultra cool pivot pocket doors. This took the owner 2 years to design out. You've got to see it to believe it. Without further ado, take it away, Mike.
Let's start the tour. First things first, I want you to touch on the location of this apartment. It's located on Central Park South, which is directly across the street from Central Park. This is a beautiful area in the park. This is the site you'll see if you stroll across the street, and it's perfect for a morning run or an evening walk with family if you were to purchase this apartment. So, an amazing location. This is the view that you'll see from your patio or your terrace, which we'll get to later on in the video. You can see some of these skyscrapers also around Central Park and Midtown, and just across the street to Central Park right here. Welcome to 106 Central Park South. This is the exterior of the building. You'll see right here, we get a little bit closer and the doorman is going to open the door to us. We're gonna enter the main lobby area. And welcome to the main lobby at 106 Central Park South. You see as we pan up slowly and from left to right, just lots of over the top, very luxurious marble everywhere you look. We're gonna walk up those stairs further back and head more towards the elevator area. There's pillars left and right and just more marble. This is the sitting area. Remember, we're gonna take an elevator up top to a apartment number 3A. Welcome to what the owner calls the Ming Jade Rotunda. It's absolutely stunning entryway. This is what you'll see as soon as you enter into apartment number 3A. As we inch up a little bit higher, so there's this really cool custom lighting fixture. That was really modern. I'd put something like this in my own apartment. But now looking back towards the door we came in, there's some really cool art pieces. We'll get into more of that later. There's so many art pieces to see. I believe the owner was an art collector. He really likes his art. But this rotunda, I was a huge fan of it. Just an amazing way to just start at this apartment. The owner Duffy's tower is very strong. We're now going to turn the corner and begin to head deeper into the apartment. Welcome to what I would call the main hallway here at the apartment. You can clearly see the influences of Antonio Gaudi. Feels very Spanish to me, also a little bit Greek. Actually, this whole area reminds me a lot of the Greek cave houses you might see that are made famous in Santorini in Greece. As you inch up a little bit higher here, you can just see how massive and long this hallway is, but also how tall it is. You can see just how tall the ceilings are as you inch up further and further, just more space as we go higher and higher. But now as we begin to kind of walk further down the hallway, you're notice off to the right on these shelves, there's so many just artifacts and little trinkets here. Again, the realtor told me it took the current owner about 2 years just to not only just build this place, but also just gather everything you see here. He was clearly a lover of art. I don't know personally what half these things are, but I was a huge fan of it. I felt like I was stepping into a museum when I was in this apartment. And then off on the opposite end of this wall, in this hallway, there's these massive murals and paintings that they're absolutely stunning. Definitely my style of art. I absolutely love them. Now we're going to enter into the first bedroom in this apartment. Again, it's a three bedroom apartment. This is basically right as you enter into the hallway off to the left. I'd probably call this one of the kids' room if I had to guess. This is definitely an apartment, I would say, for a family. So we're going to inch up a little bit higher now. This is kind of the desk space and the bedding looks very, very comfortable. It has its own ensuite bathroom as well. There's some beautiful wood paneling all over the walls. Then there's a nice little shower off to one side. I thought the sink as well was quite rare, or quite unique. There's some codfish kind of swimming around in it. I thought that was quite interesting. We're gonna go down a little bit further now down the hallway, and there's a powder room off to the left. The powder room was quite unique. It kind of had, I call, maybe granite or marble, almost like pillars on either side of the toilet. I thought that was definitely unique. I felt like a king if I was using the bathroom. And you inch up a little bit higher, and this is very interesting art piece just waiting for you. But now we're head down a little bit further and enter into the kitchen. This kitchen has state-of-the-art appliances everywhere you look, from the stovetop to the sink area to the dishwasher to the refrigerator. This is definitely a space I think meant for entertaining. The fridge is quite large, and off on this side of the kitchen there's the wine cooler and some more countertop space to prep some meals. But now we're gonna pan from left to right and get a sneak peek of the great room, which is at my absolutely favorite room this entire apartment. Now we're gonna enter the illustrious great room, and welcome to this stunning architectural masterpiece, guys. This is the 1100 square foot great room with 15 foot cathedral ceilings. As we inch up, it just takes me so long to complete this shot because it's just so large. And you see these ceilings, it actually reminds me of La Sagrada Familia in Barcelona. I've been there myself, and almost kind of like Star Trek. It kind of gives me some Starship Enterprise vibes in here, almost kind of futuristic, but again, very ultra modern, some Spanish influences, just incredibly unique. I've never seen anything like this in all my years of touring Airbnbs and hotels and apartments all over the world. So such an incredibly unique space. You can see me here chilling on the main couch area, the couch as well. It's very curved, it's very modern. I think it fits the space incredibly well. And this is the glass countertop right there. As we inch back a little bit further as well, you're gonna see there's plenty of sitting areas, plenty of options for you as well throughout this space. I really love these wooden carved chairs, but now we're heading to one corner of the great room. It's one of my favorite areas in the great room as well. In this corner, this stunning painting, definitely my style of art. There's even kind of a drink cart off to one side, but I'm not quite sure who the artist was here, but I'm pretty sure it's the same artist. For the most part, a lot of these paintings throughout this entire space, but now I'm just gonna walk to one end, and this is the dining space area. I think it's enough space for, I'd say, close to a dozen people. Again, and definitely a space meant for entertaining or for a family. There's plenty of space here. If you inch up again, we're gonna get another taste of those 15-foot cathedral ceilings. Now we're going to wander outside onto our 175 square foot private terrace. It overlooks Central Park directly across the street, as you can see from here. And if you look off to the right, you can see some of these skyscrapers in Midtown. And off to the left, you have your own little park bench, which is again overlooking Central Park. So it's just an amazing space to start your morning with your morning tea or coffee. We're going to walk back into the great room now, enter into one of the bedrooms. This is bedroom number 2 of 3, and it's one of the two bedrooms that offshoots directly from the great room. But absolutely love this bedroom again, everything from the modern artwork to all the furnishings on the bed. There's also then off in one corner of this room, a nice office space, plenty of desk space as well. So I thought that was really unique. I was not expecting that directly in this bedroom. It has its own private ensuite bathroom. Again, there's a total of 3.5 bathrooms in this entire apartment, so every single bedroom has its own ensuite bathroom. But I also want to show off these really cool revolving doors. This is in both of the bedrooms in the great room, and for privacy you can hit a button and it kind of disappears like this. Now we're going to walk back across the great room, enter into the master bedroom, which is on the opposite side of the great room. This master bedroom I found to be quite spacious. Now off on one side on the left is this nice kind of little desk or table area. I thought probably good for just touching up on makeup or doing the finishing touches before going out on the town. Now on the opposite end in this corner is past my favorite painting in the entire apartment. Just for me, I just love how the yellow pops so well in this painting. We're head a little bit further back now to the master bathroom. Again, it's ensuite attached to the bedroom. And there's, again, just under 3,000 square feet of living space this entire apartment. So much space again for a family. This is the master bathroom for the couple, and there's two sinks, plenty of countertop. There's the mirror. On the left is the toilet. On the right is a very large walk-in shower. But now I save one of my favorite rooms for last. This is the absolutely massive walk-in closet. There's so much space here. Whoever, you know, has bought, or the current owner who will buy this apartment, definitely has to be a shopper, because you could fit hundreds of outfits into this entire closet. It's basically partitioned off into three different sections I found, but just walking around, there's just so many shelves. If you look up, there's even some chandeliers. Like, who puts chandeliers inside of a closet? Absolutely loved it. That would do it, guys, for a tour of this incredible $7 million ultra modern apartment listing. I'm gonna put all the information again to this apartment listing, to John and the Corcoran Group, down in the video description. Also, be sure to follow me on Instagram at Michael Chow for some behind the scenes action. Until then, I will see you in next week's video.